we know that whenever demand is inelastic, all right, when you decrease price, revenue increases. All right, you can check that in your notes. So this actually confirms that when you decrease price, you have an inelastic demand. You decrease price, revenue is going to increase. Okay, so the question on your exam on this part is going to be almost the same, but not exactly. The difference is that I'm going to give you guys x equals instead of p equals. Is that okay? Are you guys listening? I think on one of your tests in a smart lab, I gave you that question where you had x equals something, all right? And you're supposed to find the price elasticity of demand. So on your exam, I'm going to give you guys x equals. To solve this question, you have to solve for p. Is that okay? And then everything else follows. All right? Does that mean the same?
Demand.
Right. Now, question number 9. I think you saw this on one of the exams. So you can use, there are two models actually. You can use this, where B is any number, okay, and or you can also use this. All right. So let's say we want to use the first one. If you want to use the first model, this question is easier. You have y equals C B T divided by T. Now T is called, capital T is called the time constant, or you can say the period. Is that okay? You can say the period. B is the growth rate. All right. So in this question, we're told that the initial amount is 250,000. Is that okay? So we know C is 250,000. So right away, C is 250,000. What else do we know? The value of Y of the home is tripled every 25 years. And so B must be 3. And then capital T must be 25. As I said, capital T is the period. So that's the time taken for the value to triple. Is that okay? And so that's more than the period. And so capital T is 25. The growth rate is 3. Is that okay? Because the value triples every 25 years. So using these parameters, you can write out the formula. So it's going to be 250, 3T over 25. That's it. All right. So the second part says, how long does it take for the value of the home to double? So the initial one is 250,000. Then Y is going to be what?
500,000. There you go.
250, 3T, 25. And so you have 2, right? And so you take ln of this side. So ln of 2 is going to be t over 25 ln of 3. And so t is going to be 25 ln of 2 divided by ln of 3. Now, if you decide to use the other model, right, so you have E equals C, so C is 25, so 25, 250,000, EKT, then you would have to find the value of K by using the information given. We're told that when t equals 25, y is going to be 750, right? Because it says that the value triples. So when t equals 25, so 750, 1, 2, 3, 250, 1, 2, 3, e, 25k. Is that okay? That's if you use this, the natural exponential model. So in that case, this is the same as 3 equals e25k. So you take ln of each side. So you have ln of 3 equals 25k, right? Take ln of left side, ln of right side. So you have ln of 3 equals 25k. So k equals ln of 3 divided by 25. And so you just write whatever it is. So this is going to be y equals 250,000 e, and the value of k that you have found here. The value of k that you have found here. You put that there, up here. Okay.
That's 13 over 25.
No, times t. Okay, I don't know what that is, so let me still write. So this is how you find k. You plug that value here into that equation. Is that okay? Now, you go, so the way you find t is very similar to that. Okay, so the question on your exam, question number 9, is also similar to this, very similar. I can ask you to find, so I can say the value of y doubles every 10 years, or I can also say the value is half. Alright, so in that case, if you want to use this, b is going to be what? If the value is half, what is going to be b?
0.5.
Yeah, 0.5.
Or 1.
Yeah. Okay, and so everything follows. Alright.